Hello guys, how are you doing? Let's dig in our course. And before we explain how to start using and configure Xdebug, we should know how does Xdebug work with PHP and your IDE. So in this video, we're gonna explain how Xdebug works, what are steps you should take to start using Xdebug, and how Xdebug communicate with your IDE. This takes three main steps. The first step is that IDE listens on a specified port for communication with Xdebug and waiting for the incoming calls from Xdebug. The second step is that Xdebug, which is already installed on the PHP web server, calls back on your IDE on a specific port and transfers information about the application runtime. At some point, Xdebug communicates with IDE on this specific port, which your IDE started to listen on the first step. Then, Xdebug starts to communicate and send information about application runtime to IDE. Once a debugging session starts, Xdebug and IDE begin to communicate via Debugging protocol. This protocol, created to allow debugging engines and IDE to communicate and transfer information about the application runtime. So again, the main steps are, first one, IDE start to listen on a specific port, which is 9000 or 9003, we're going to see that. The second one, Xdebug itself starts to call back the IDE on this specific port. Then, once the debugging session starts, the IDE and Xdebug transfer data through Debugging protocol, which is created specifically for debugging process between debugging engines like Xdebug and your IDE. Now we are aware of the way Xdebug and IDE communicate with each other. So let's explain it more clearly. Just imagine you have a web server exists in your PHP installation, and the web server such as Nginx or Apache, if you use one of them or both of them. This is your web server, and this web server may exist in your host if you want, for example, to debug your development host, or maybe in Docker or even in a remote server. The first step to take is that to install Xdebug extension inside your PHP in your web server. Then you can imagine here you have your IDE and your browser. IDE like Visual Studio Code or PHP Storm, and browsers like Firefox or Chrome or any other browser. The first thing happens is that your IDE starts to listen on port number 9000 or 9003, depending on your own configurations. And for sure, you can change the port if you have 9000 or 9003 ports already used in another services. Then you connect your IDE or browser with the web server. As we said, Xdebug is now installed on the web server with PHP extensions. So when you send a request, you send an Xdebug session ID. This session ID allows Xdebug to know that this request contains debugging. This means that you want to debug, not only send a request or execute a script. After that, the web server starts to call back your IDE on the port 9003, and send the init packet. This init packet starts to communicate via Debugging protocol. So, as we said, the first step is that your IDE send a request to the web server, for example, to send a request on the login route. Then Xdebug sends a communication start to port 9003, which is IDE listens on. After that, the IDE connects back with Xdebug and send it information about the breakpoints or the things you want to debug. Afterward, the web server and the IDE start to communicate via Debugging protocol. And so the debugging process starts here in this port. Then breakpoints started to send information about the debugging process and so on. Actually, all these details you don't need to know, but you just needed to know an overview about it, how it works. After the debugging session finishes, the web server sends all the rest data to the browser to execute the code and to view, for example, the login page. Okay, let's recap what we already said. Firstly, the process of listening on port number 9000 or 9003 happens. Secondly, you start to call Xdebug from your browser through sending a request, such as sending a request to the login page. Thirdly, Xdebug starts to call your IDE to initialize the debugging session. Fourthly, the IDE calls Xdebug and sends it back the breakpoints, for example, to inform it to make a breakpoint at this line or at this part of code or debug this script and so on. Fifthly, the IDE and the Xdebug initialize the protocol to start communication with each other. And the final step is that the web server starts to execute the rest of the script after the end of the debugging session, and then send the response to the browser to display the login page or the home page or any other page, or just execute the PHP response. Okay, now we know how Xdebug works and deals with PHP installation. So we are now ready to use Xdebug. And in the next video, we will learn how to install Xdebug using Pickle or the Withered from Xdebug itself. Thanks for watching, and for any questions, write them down in the comments or contact me via any social media. Thank you, and see you next time.